Do your maps look like this, and you're wondering what you can improve to make it look better, like this, then this is the perfect tutorial for you. Make sure to also watch till the end, because I'm giving something away. So first, we are here on the map, and as you saw, it's pretty boring. The players spawn here, and they do not see anything. Not a message, what is new on the map, or nothing really. They did not see anything here. That's pretty boring. So what you can do is create custom stuff in your Fortnite game. For example, we are going to create superpowers. There are basic ones that you can all create, even create a 1.0. So first create classes. We want to have 4 superpowers. So we are going to create 5 class selectors and designers. Since we need a neutral class, that is just normal. Now we go inside of the settings of all of them, switch this to class, and I'm gonna just disable all the settings. Yeah, that's perfect. And now we're going to do the same with the designers. Class identifier 1, and we don't need to change anything here. So first, we're going to create the neutral class that's already made. Class identifier, class slot 1. And now you see, first class, it has nothing in it. We can just name it neutral, so you know what you're dealing with. Change this to 2 and continue with the counting. 3, 4, 5. The first class is going to get double shield, so just go into the class selector, make sure there's 2 and here 2, and then you can turn on this setting, max shields, and turn to 200. That way the player that gets class 2 will receive 200 shield, and we're already done here. Let's just continue with class 3. This player will have very fast movement, 1.7, and the gravity too low, so he can jump higher and make fun stuff. This class, we're going to add fly to the player fly, and then make sure to make it slow on the island settings, because otherwise it will be very fast. So 1 is very, very nice, and then just make sure to check it. We're just going to rename it fly. We're gonna rename this too, to movement, and also this one to double shield. Now the last one, you can be as creative as you want. You can add specific weapons that the player will get granted or other stuff. I'm just going to give him instant reload, there you go. You can just also check if you did everything right. Name it instant reload, and there you go. Now you have a neutral class and 4 different classes that will give the player superpowers. So now we are going to create conditional devices. So the player has to pay with gold to get the power. So the first one will be double shield. Just call it double shield. Reaction time, I'm just going to get 2 seconds. Key items required, it's gonna cost 50 gold to get the item, get the power, and that's about it. Now we need to go to the class that is double shield, the class selector, and change to class when player activates the conditional button. And that's how easy it is. Now we're going to do this with the other powers as well. Now you can just take the devices and just drag it under your base, or wherever you like it to drag them. Now we need a reset power button. We're just going to do this with a button. Now class to switch to Obi-Wan, and just connect it with the button. And now change the text, reset powers, turn the interaction time to 2, and also changed up the radius. I'm going to change it to 1. 1 is pretty good. And I like to put it in this corner right here. That's about right. Now what you can do is create a modeling tool. You can create a random texture for it. I'm just going to do it very quick. I'm just also going to change this to a custom mesh, like this. This looks nice. And now I'm just going to make it bigger. And there we have a nice button. Now what you can do is create a billboard and write down reset build, reset power, and place it here in a nice way. What I'm going to do is create my own one. For that I'm going to use Photoshop. So now we have it in game. We need to create a plane for that. Rotate it the way we want it to be. Turn off the collision. And then another very important step is to do this. You are not required to do this, but I'm just going to create a 360 material so it always rotates in the direction the player is looking. If you need a tutorial on this, just make sure to watch this. I'm just going to speedrun through it. So now we're done. I need to drag it into the material, and you see it's following my camera position. Just place it over the button. Let's just make sure we turn this setting off. Very important setting. Make sure to change this to no mid maps, just to make sure the image is always high quality and never is like blurry at the beginning of the game. Maybe you know what I mean. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the part where we created superpowers. Now you can do the same thing for the powers. So let's just create a similar thing. We can just take this material and this, copy and paste it, change the color on this, maybe to like yellow, change this to like, I don't know, maybe red. Now you can do the same with the powers, as I said, just place it over this. Let's just create a glowing material because I don't like the way it looks. So we're going to create a glowing material. Now, very, very easy, convert the parameter, change color. Now select the value you want to have. We're going to have it in blue. Create another parameter just by holding down S. Glow intensity. Create a multiplayer. Create both with each other. And now connect it with emissive color. Turn this to 1. And you see it's a normal brightness. Now turn this into like 3. And you see it's already glowing. I'm just going to test out with like 10. 10 is a good value. And this looks very, very nice. I'm also going to add a normal texture just so when players look at it they have something like a nice structure on it. You can just go into the folder and select a normal texture that Fortnite already gives. You will not be able to see this, but it's still very nice. Now what you can do is right click on it, create a material instance and glow, for example red. Now go into the material instance and create another one, for example yellow. Now I just can go into the material instance and you can change the glow intensity and the color to, this is red, this looks about right. Now do the same thing with the yellow, change color to yellow, and now you have 3 different colors, so we can just drag them to this and we can search down here. We can search them here, for example search the glow, we will see them, or we can just drag them into it. So this is going to be blue, it's going to be yellow, and this looks nice with the red. I'm going to change the color of the platforms too. Now, people do not know which power you will give them. So just by simply creating like text again, or even creating your own icon. I'm going to create a few icons so you don't have to use them, and I'm going to put them on my free Discord channel so you can just use them however you like. And yeah, these are the icons, and we're just going to do the same thing, but we are going to add a nice bounce into the materials and also a glint. So make sure to watch the video and make sure to open up the material and turn on two-sided, so you will be able to see it on both sides like this. If you're fine with this one and you don't need like nothing fancy or a very nice thing, and it's completely fine if you leave it like this. I don't like it, so I'm going to add a nice glint effect to it. You will be able to get it from my Discord too. So when you import the glint function, you can also create it yourself. I'm just going to run through it. So this is the glint function. You can create it yourself. It's not that hard. Or you can just go into my Discord and drag it into the materials, into the map. Now open up the material of your double shield ability. Go into the material and copy this. Copy it inside of this, create a lerp by holding down L, connect with the alpha, create a parameter, call it glow intensity, connect this with your base color, but we're going to make the turn this to unlit, so connect this with your emissive color, and there you go. You see, now we have a nice glint effect on the material, which is very nice. We're going to increase the brightness of the material too, so just create this. Multiply, connect with lerp, and then connect it with the emissive color. Now you see, it's way brighter and it looks way better. So find a double shield ability, place this right in the middle, and there you have a nice looking double shield power. You can also add a text like here and put it down under, like under this, and name it double shield. You don't have to do this, but you could do this. Go into the powers. So now we're going to create a nice bouncy material. I'm just going to speedrun through it. So now you have this. This value is to move X how far you want it to move. I'm just going to do this on 2.6. And this is the speed, how fast it will move. Now you can just check, apply this, save. And there you can check how fast it moves. It's way too fast. So turn this down to like 1.54. Test it. That's way better. And in my opinion, it looks perfect. It's not too much, not too low. It's just right on. Now we're going to create the other ones too. So that's very easy. Duplicate this. Go into the materials. Just duplicate this. And rename it. I'm just going to add in the fly texture, apply, and save. Let's check if this is fly. No, it's this power. Just have to make sure to add in the fly. And see, it's doing the same thing. There we go. Now you have four nice superpowers with custom pictures that you can freely use. And this looks already better with the reset button. Just please make sure to have this setting on. Otherwise, it will be blurry for the players joining. And you don't want players to see a blurry picture instantly when they join into your map. So this looks very nice. And let's just test this out. Launch a session and test if it works. And you also need to make sure that you do the same thing on the other side after you tested it and see if it works. Now you will spawn and you see it's already brighter and it looks just very, very nice with the bright colors on the map instantly. And the fact that this is not blurry or anything, I would definitely make this one a little bit smaller, and also this one. Now let's pick up gold and let's test. You see, we have 200 shield now. Let's just try to reset it. So this one works. Let's test if the super movement works. And it works perfectly fine. And with the glow effect, it just looks very, very clean, nice. Now let's test the fly ability. You see the super movement is gone. Now we have the fly power. Just double jump and you see we are flying. Turn on instant reload and test it out. Double jump to see if any other power is selected. No. Now just take a weapon, shoot it, and you see it's instantly reloading. So it's working perfectly fine. In the next tutorial, we will get to how to get an HUD and how to manage them. And if you like the tutorial, make sure to like and subscribe for more. Make sure to join my Discord. There you will be able to get this free assets just for free. Just join the Discord and I have a free channel there where I give away stuff. You will be able to get this texture and these ones too. And also the glint effect, so it looks like this. And this is part one of how to improve your maps and your Red Hills Blue maps, because you can add this to any other maps of yours.